I'm Obed Haraseb. I'm working now 10 years at City of Windhoek as a cremation officer at crematorium, part of City of Windhoek. So, I cremate different part of bodies, not actually COVID-19, but before, from babies up to very, very old people. So. There is nothing that I can say I cremate this body, I don't cremate that body. So it doesn't matter, as long as family requests for cremation, if it's even if it's stillbirth, then of stillborn or stillbirth, then I will do the cremation. If all the necessary documents are completed, then for sure. The undertakers will bring the body for cremation. The car will come up to here, and then That's if all the paperwork are ready. If all the paperwork are ready. So practically they bring the body, then they will come to park the car here. We are going to use this left. Top left. We transport the body from We are going to transport the body with the forklift from the car. We are going to put it in here, turn it around. After the coffin is secured with the lock, we are not to move around. It locks the coffin to remain in the same position, not to move around. Yeah. And then before cremation, if there is bodies, then I will put the body here with this. Most of the time, I will take the body from the undertaker's car, and then from here directly to the oven. Cremation plan, and then transport it with us up to here. Certain degrees before I open up. Then if the degrees are okay, then it's just, we are in buttons here, but it's very close to the door. Mostly I'm using this one for safety reasons. And then our first third one for that door, you see the door halfway, to left out. This is the door. This is the door. Then your left out. If I put in the body will remain there on that stone. It's a brakes. The machine is been built with brakes on the inside. And then take out the filter, body filter, and then the door will slide down, and the cremation process will start. And then operating, it's from other side to operate the machine and check out the machine and everything. It will be other side. Use fire on the body. I use the wind. This is the wind from from top. Mm-hmm. This one is from top. This one is from the sides, and this one is from underneath. Its pipes were going in the machine like this. So if the body start burning, the coffin, it's together with the coffin start burning, and then we switch off the burner. And then I help the body with the wind. Little wind, little fire. More wind, more fire. Mm. So I must operate that the machine cannot overheat because of the wind and whatsoever. And if it's not necessary, then I will take down the wind, but it must be done twice, two by two. If I put on side and loop, it's from the side. It means the wind is coming in from that side, and then I can see, this is the window where I monitor the body.
Okay, so you can see
I can see the body.
Okay.
But it depends on
how hot is the machine and the temperature inside. So I must be careful, I cannot just open up and close up, because I must also monitor most of the things also here. If it's more than 0 degrees here, it's positive. It means if I open up here, while is it positive, the flames can come out. Yeah, so I must monitor. So it means if I'm here, I must be careful. And most of the time, I try to remain here, not to focus on the office. Then I will make a mistake. Mm. If I'm here, then I must focus here. Then I must not run out from the office and quickly open up and then. It means I must be relaxed, I must be cool, and then it's like nothing. Then I operate the machine very good. Two stages, as I say, main chamber and after chamber. In main chamber, it takes plus minus, let me say, hour. It depends on from the weight of the body. Mm-hmm. If it's a bigger body, then it takes sometimes hour and a half, sometimes hour 45 minutes. It depends on. But if it's smaller person, thinner person, and it takes, sometimes it takes only 45 minutes to 30 minutes. Yeah, it depends on from the, how big the body is. If the bigger body bends a little bit longer, smaller bodies, yeah.
And then how many do you burn in a day?
It depends on from the machine. I cannot say I will burn today 8 bodies and start burning 8 bodies. The machine is also, it's like communicating with me, telling me I am too hot. If it's too hot, then I can cremate at least 5 bodies a day. But if I see the machine is working nicely, I can cremate up to 8, then I can cremate up to 8. Mostly at the first day, then I can cremate at least 4 or 5. But from the third day, not the second day, but from the third day and upwards, then I can cremate more. Yeah, then most of those cremations is without the burners. I just put on the burners, make flames, and then I switch off the burners, and it's cremating on wind. If the body starts burning there, inside the machine is like this. So everything falls at this rotating grid.
Mm-hmm.
It means if all the pieces of the body falls down and remain here, then I will come and turn around. And then it will move up to here. Whatever happens here inside, I will monitor from here, but it's dark. It's not like the first chamber, the main chamber. So this is, I cannot say the important area, but the whole thing is important, but this is the last stage of the body, the bones to be bent, to become, no, not become, that only the bones must remain, the rest of everything will be finished here, and only the bones will remain here. From here, I will turn around again, put it on the trolley like this, standing here. In that trolley, and from there I will take it out, cool it off at least for 40 minutes to, it depends on how hot the bones are, and from there, this is the cleaning process. My ladies were cleaning, that's why the things are here on top, they were cleaning. If they clean, they leave it here. If the bones cool down, from here, I put it here. Here I separate the body, the needles and everything with this magnet. This is a magnet. This was part of what, it's part of coffin. Then I clean out this. I clean out this. And then from here I put the bones in here after I take it out, after I take it those needles and everything. And from here I put it in. Yeah.
Not every bone comes to this stage.
Yeah.
Yeah. Most bones at that level, they also have been bent, they become ash.
Yeah.
Only a few bones, and It depends also on the person's long medical history. The guys with cancer and all those things, yeah, the bone structure are very hard. They take normally long to make, yeah.
This is the stones or not? This is the stones, maybe I can say stones of iron bars or whatsoever, round ones. They are the ones who crush the bones, that the bones can become powder. And after the crushing, maybe plus minus for 25 minutes, all the bones come through here.
They become ash now.
Then when it's ashes,
it's meal.
Yeah, then. In this plastic, it seals, né? See, the plastic can seal it nicely. It seals. Cremation, it's very cheap. Really, it's very cheap and clean and fast process of all everything. If you go on burial, then the amounts that relatives are taking out, it's three times more than normal cremations. So I would prefer if public really if they can cremate. It's very cheap, it's clean, it's a good fast process. Yeah.